Drainage is generally described as the river system of an area through which that particular region or area complete their necessity of water, complete its necessity of water. In this chapter, drainage basically it has divided into the three broader parts. First, drainage patterns, which includes important drainage patterns as trellis or rectangular pattern. Pattern means through that structure, river flow from their origin at the mountains till their mouth. So first, as a trellis, rectangular. Second, dendritic pattern, dendritic, dendritic pattern. Third, parallel drainage pattern. Fourth, radial pattern. Fourth, as radial pattern. And fifth, centripetal pattern. So these are the important drainage pattern through which a river flow during their courses from the mountainous areas where the river originates till the mouth where the river it fall under the larger water body. Clear? So these are the important patterns. Next, second in this chapter, drainage systems. Broadly, there are two drainage systems: Himalayan River system, and Peninsular River system. Himalayan River system divided into the three parts: Indus and their tributaries, where they are originates, which of the areas they drain, how they contribute, which of the dams are constructed on such rivers, all of the tributaries of Indus and their tributaries. Afterwards, it go towards Pakistan, and finally it fall in a Arabian Sea. We will discuss about them in a detail. Indus, then Ganga River system and their tributaries, all the tributaries: Yamuna, Ghaggar, Gandak, Son, Ken, Betwa, Kosi, Damodar. All these are the tributaries of a Ganga. And last, Brahmaputra River system. Clear? Then the Peninsular River system divided into the two parts: eastward flowing rivers and westward flowing rivers like as a Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari, Mahanadi, Tungabhadra. These are the eastward flowing rivers, and the westward flowing rivers are Narmada, Tapi. Clear? Narmada and Tapi. And third part of this chapter is as the landforms carved by the river landforms carved by the river during its course. Throughout their course, when river originates from the mountains till the mouth of a river, it also flows through the plains also. What kind of the landforms built or carved by the river? All these we will discuss in detail. Clear? Yes, Ashmit.
Sir, एक बार drainage pattern थोड़ा बताना.
Drainage pattern. Have patience. So let's start one by first. Drainage patterns. What it means? Drainage pattern. Drainage pattern is a spatial arrangement. Drainage pattern is a spatial arrangement and form of drainage system in terms of geometrical shapes in the areas of different types of rocks, geological structure means as a mountains, plains, plateaus, geological structure and climatic conditions, all these three are the factors which are affecting the drainage patterns. I'm repeating again, the factors which are affecting as a drainage patterns are factors which are affecting the drainage patterns are first, types of rocks. Harder rocks are not possible to erode by the river. They are flow with the river water along slopes of mountains, are rock particles. They flow with the river water. Clear? Second, as the geological structure in mountainous areas, in plateau regions, river eroded more materials as compared to the plains. In plains, river deposited the sediments. Clear? So they are also influencing the drainage patterns. Third, climatic conditions. In climatic conditions, the rain, if the rain more occur in any of a area under such circumstances, the volume of a water sudden increase in a river. So that kind of a river, it may cause floods, which will be results as a floodplains of Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. Floodplains, it is as the climatic conditions. And fourth one, as the gradient or slope also influence the drainage patterns. Slope, generally the river, it do as a more erosion on a steep sided slopes of mountains as compared to the gentle slopes, more erosion, the deeper erosion has occurred on a steep sided slopes of a mountains as compared to the gentle slopes. Yes, Ashmit. And spatial arrangement and forms of drainage system in terms of geometrical shapes in the areas of different types of rocks, geological structure, climatic conditions and slope or gradient. So the first pattern is a trellis pattern. Trellis pattern, T-R-E-L-L-I-S, trellis pattern. Trellis, first. Trellis or a rectangular pattern. Rectangular pattern. In this pattern, the tributaries can be, this is as the main river, tributaries can be meet main river at right angles is known as trellis pattern. This is as the river. All these are the tributaries. All these are the tributaries, and in between of a tributaries, these are the rocky landmasses which can't eroded by the river. These landmasses not eroded by the river. Not eroded by the river. Main river. So as the trellis pattern. Trellis pattern is generally formed in rocky surfaces of plateau. ROCKY, rocky surfaces of plateau. Example, Tapi River, TAPI. Example, Tapi River, TAPI. Done? Yes, Ashmit. So, as trellis pattern, second is a dendritic pattern. Dendritic pattern. Dendritic pattern. It is also known as a tree-shaped pattern. Tree-shaped pattern. Dendritic or a T-shaped pattern is the most common and widespread pattern to be found on the Earth's surface. It is generally found in plains. Means leveled areas in plains where river and its tributaries flow according to the slope of a region. In this pattern, the tributaries coming from different directions and meet in main river. Clear? Main river joined by the tributaries looks like as a tree-shaped pattern. Example, Ganga, G-A-N-G-A, Ganga, Mitansh. Mitansh. So let me continue. Example, Ganga. Ganga joined with their tributaries, Yamuna, Ghaggar, Gandak. Write anyone two names. Ghaggar, Gandak, Son, S-O-N-E, Kosi, K-O-S-I, Yamuna, any two, one, two names of the tributaries of a Ganga. Ganga joined by their tributaries, Yamuna, Ghaggar, Gandak, Son, Ken, Betwa, Damodar, Damodar, by making as a such pattern. All these rivers joined Ganga at plains. At plains. Clear? Is that clear? Second, as the dendritic pattern. Third, parallel drainage pattern. 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 This is as the direction of a river. Direction of river. Parallel drainage pattern comprises. Parallel drainage pattern comprises numerous rivers which are numerous rivers which are parallel to each other, parallel to each other, and follow the regional slope. This pattern is developed. This pattern is developed on uniformly sloping areas of coastal plains, C-O-A-S-T-A-L, coastal plains. Example, Narmada Tapi, they flow parallel to each other. Narmada and Tapi, the westward flowing rivers, parallel to each other. The reason behind the these two rivers parallel to each other as the first one as a Narmada, second as a Tapi, Satpura. Satpura mountains are present in between of it, which makes as the division. These two are flow parallel to each other. Clear? Example clear? Fourth pattern is a radial. Radial drainage pattern. Radial drainage pattern. R-A-D-I-A-L. Till there, any questions, any queries? Of drainage pattern, streams flow in different directions from a central peak, example, Mansarovar Lake in Tibet. Mansarovar present in a Kailash mountains in Tibet, from which the three rivers are originate. First, Brahmaputra in eastward side. In this region, the Brahmaputra is known as a Sangpo. Brahmaputra in east, Indus in northwest, and Satluj in southwest. Satluj River, it flows towards the southwest. Brahmaputra in east, it starts to move towards the east and enters in Arunachal Pradesh. Indus, it moves towards the northwest and enters in a Ladakh region of a J&K. And Satluj moves towards the southwest. southwest originates from the Mansarovar. It moves towards the southwest and enters in India through the Lahul Spiti district of Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh. Clear example? Example clear? Next one. Last pattern, centripetal pattern. Centripetal pattern. Centripetal pattern. Centripetal pattern. Centripetal pattern. Centripetal means when different streams move from different directions towards central part due to slope of an area, due to slope of an area is known as centripetal pattern. So here are different streams are moving towards a common center. Example, Vullar and Dal Lake in J&K. Vullar and Dal Lake. These are the one of the freshwater lakes of India. Vullar and Dal Lake. So they are basically situated in a valleys of a central parts of the Himalayas. Snow melts from the mountainous areas. It moves towards the central low-lying areas. That particular low-lying area filled with the water named as a Vullar or Dal. Vullar and Dal Lake in J&K. Vullar and Dal Lake. Clear? Yes, Ashmit. Is that clear? Any other questions? Any questions? So these are the five major drainage patterns through which all the rivers, they are flowing as per the slope of an area. Clear? As per the slope of an area. Now the next part is the figure 3.3. These are the landforms carved by the river at its three stages: upper course, middle course, and lower course. Upper course, middle course, and lower course. Clear? Second part as the landforms. Landforms carved by the river. Till there, any questions? Description regarding the such landforms. It's not marked in NCRT. So let's start the DC stages. Stages of river. There are the three stages of river. First stage, stage one, upper course. This is known as the upper course or youthful stage. Second one is a stage two of river, middle course. This is a mature stage. Clear? And third one is a stage three, old stage or a lower course or old stage. Why old? Because river, it can't carry the material, then it finally submerge in a larger water body. It may be a gulf, bay, sea or ocean. So during these three stages, river carved at different types of landforms. First, in youthful stage, river make as the gorges, G-O-R-G-E, gorge. Second one as V-shaped valleys, V-shaped valleys, V-shaped valleys. And third, waterfall, waterfall, waterfall. Clear? Waterfall. We will discuss about them with their diagrams in later. Middle course, important landforms, alluvial fans, F-A-N-S, alluvial fans. Second one, meanders, meanders. Third, Oxbow Lake, Oxbow Lake. Fourth, floodplains, floodplains, floodplains. Fourth as the floodplains. And last, braided streams, braided streams, braided streams, braided streams. Clear? And old stage, delta, distributaries, and estuaries, distributaries, and estuaries. Estuaries, E-S-T-U-A-R-I-E-S, estuaries, estuaries.